What is up, risk takers? Welcome to the Kill Pete Strategy. I am Pete. I am a top player in Risk Global Domination, a daily release on YouTube. I'm doing weekday streams on Twitch. If you are interested in getting better at the game of Risk, I invite you to subscribe to my channel and come along the ride with me. What we're doing today is we're playing a five-player classic fix game. For the series, we're going to be playing World Domination on the classic map, auto setup, 60-second turn, and we have one neutral bot to start. Fix cards, balance splits dice with alliances on. Fog, blizzards, and portals are off, and I'm in the final position of the human players in the first position. We have the orange player, Samira, the pale, flying the flag of Canada and playing as orange. In the second position, we have Ansel Muttonchop 22 from Spain, playing as purple. In position 3, we have Chris Go, also from Spain, playing as blue. In position 4, we have General Verk 15227 from United States of America, playing as yellow. And in the final position of the humans, we have myself, and this is Bird Blintz from Bangladesh in camo. And would you look at that Australia gift right off the bat from the first turn. We have a turn one Australia. So everybody's going to have to watch out for what is one of the biggest gifts you've ever seen. Today's episode is sponsored by Into the AM. Into the AM is a team of artists who share a common vision. They turn clothing into a canvas that expresses what drives us. They've developed premium apparel that elevates self-expression and provides unparalleled comfort for wherever your passions take you. If you're the type of person who's into looking good and feeling good, Into the AM has provided us with a 10% discount on all their products. You can redeem this offer by clicking the link in the description below or by using discount code Pete at checkout. And once again, thank you, Into the AM, for sponsoring this video. Trying to get a sense of where everyone's planning on going. That is the upside of being last to act. Yellow card skips on their first turn. Okay. I have a bit of a distribution. I saw that orange wanted to be in the North American position. I'm going to let them have it. I think it makes the most sense for me to start in South America, despite the fact that I don't love that start. And we'll work from there. So first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to want to see if I want to be friends with any of the players in the game. We'll offer them alliance requests now on my turn so everyone sees that it happens. I'm going to get an easy take on the white player so it doesn't start stacking where I'm trying to get my troops. And then I can hopefully look to move more of my troops in that direction over the next couple of turns. This move gives blue hopefully a road out and yellow hopefully a road out to get their troops out of South America so that I can take it. White player puts in six troops on its five remaining territories, and those territories are going to act as pseudo blizzards because the neutral bot will not attack for the entire game. It will just be stacking here. So whoever is going for Europe is going to have a hard road to take it. I figure orange wants in North America. If orange wants, what they should do is they should move their five in. But in order to let my five out, they have to get it out of the way. So if orange was a good player, we would see them back this five off to let me retreat my five out, which they do not do. So that tells me immediately that orange is not very good. We see a very strong Australia start. Purple player starting out the second turn with a 13-stack guard on the Australia turtle. This could be a conquering game for purple if they play it well. All right, blue would like to involve themselves in Africa, it seems. Okay. Nobody's moving out of my South America. Okay, I'm fine with this. I will just continue to take my cards in South America. For now. And then we'll be playing the classic South American position where you take the South America bonus, but you also maintain an exterior position taking cards in Asia. And that is usually how the South American position works. I can sort of tell where everyone wants to go now. So obviously purple is in South America. I figure blue wants to go for Africa. I figure yellow wants to go for Europe. And I figure orange wants to go for North America, which leaves me in South America because there's five players. If I am friendly to the North American player and he takes North America and I eventually take South America, this will have the additional advantage of allowing us to have a non-militarized Mexico-Venezuela corridor so that the North American position can move this way and the South American position can move this way and we don't have to stack in that middle territory. Not surprised that blue knocked my three, leaving yellow in a very hard road to take Europe. Unless yellow gets the bright idea to move in to South America and contest me, which he hasn't done yet. Berenouf. I'm going to get my card in Northern Asia at the moment. So this move shows goodwill, the orange player. And he's going to likely react to that in some way, because that's exactly what he wanted me to do. I'm still a little bit worried about yellow deciding that they have more material and they want South America instead. My position is bad. I think I'm easily in the worst position on this board. I'm at 20 troops. I have less troops than the bot. Might be a bit of a hard road to not just die. I think I'm in big trouble. I think yellow decides to take South America now. I would if I was him. No, he's going to get a card in Europe. Great. So I'm sitting in the southern tip, South America with 14 stack. Probably take it next turn because I have a bonus. That will enable me to take and guard South America, but I'll still be decently far behind. Do we see blue roll that 7? That 7 is only going to increase. If blue was trying to take... Oh, and they block me from SA. That sucks. That really sucks for my game. Looks like yellow's thinking about hitting it, though. Yeah, they decide against it. They're going to hit an orange 3. Yeah. They're moving into Australia. Very clever. All right. If you guys are familiar with my position on the no Australia, no win strat, we see this again and again and again. Players, idiot suiciding for Australia. Don't do this. It's best to not take it in the first place, even if you were given it for free. We can't fault the purple player for taking Australia, but look at this. You see it again and again and again. Players going full idiot suicide for the Australia position. All right, I'm going to give blue one turn to get that stack out. So I'm going to indicate to it, and I'm going to tell him that I have to attack his territory. I'm not going to do it this turn. I'm going to give him a chance to get his stack out, which hopefully engenders goodwill in both the African position and the North American position. Orange is going to finish NA now. Now we see purple go into Australia, and the idiot suicide fest continued. Yes, so okay. So we will soon be in a three-player game. So what does the future have for this game? Yellow's fucked. Yellow and purple will eliminate each other. So we will end up in a three-player game where blue's sphere of influence is most of Europe and Africa. Orange's sphere of influence is North America and Northern Asia. My sphere of influence is going to be South America and hopefully a position in Asia. Actually, maybe my line play this game. He's going to leave. He's going to pull the 13 out. This is a good move. He's going to move his 13 out and let purple retake. Either that or he's going to let him and let purple and yellow just die. They will both eliminate each other. He moves out, right? Yeah, he runs away. Oh, interesting. Would you look at that? Okay, I'm going to maintain a 10 stack in Asia. I'm going to go take. And now I expect to have stable borders with blue and orange. Blue, in order to take their bonus, is going to have to hit an 8 stack of the bot. That stack's only getting larger, so you, sooner rather than later, you hit it. Orange is guarding against the bot here, which makes no sense, because that bot's never going to attack. You can actually use the bot's 11 as a guard. This is why I dislike playing with neutral bots at the start. I think neutral bots and fixed cards are very useful because a player botting out late game can accidentally win. But neutral bots at the outset should absolutely be automated. So they keep taking cards and they don't act like blizzards. If I wanted to play with blizzards, I would have played with blizzards. Okay, purple sets in, is going to retake Australia. Someone should probably be thinking about killing yellow for their cards. Who's going to set and take Africa now? Yep. And poor yellow, sitting in that awful, awful Europe where the bot's just going to stack on his three territories forever. No one's going to hit an 11, a 7, and an 8 to take Europe unless they're overwhelmingly strong. We can maybe swoop in and take the Australia bonus, but you don't want it early, right? Because you just see that type of idiot stuff happen again and again and again. No Australia, no win. Well, no thank you. Orange is playing an excellent North America game. They should win this. If I was playing the orange game, I would move the 25 to Kamchatka. I'd move the 19 to Kamchatka, and I'd move the 8 to Kamchatka, and I'd wait for the red player to backdoor me. And if they never do, then I can just guard on a... I can guard the North America position on a single territory. Or similarly, until this 12 leaves, I don't have to worry about reinforcing Iceland. Yellow's still getting their card, but they look like the fish now, sitting on 24 and 4. I'm not going to set and waste. My set taking the infantry trade. I want a 10 set, so I'm sitting on 5 cards. 18 troops in Asia, 23 troops guarding Brazil. Bot reinforces 3. We now have a 13, 10, and a 9 to break through in order to take Europe. Yellow is in a dilly of a pickle. So purple has now effectively card blocked yellow. In order for yellow to get a card, they have to push in to either blue's position or white. Does yellow accept his defeat, maintain the noose that has been tightened around his neck, or does he knock that 10 out and continue to take cards? No, he accepts. Yellow maintains the card block. What do you do if you're blue? I think blue is in a bad spot. Unless blue moves that 11 off. The 11 stays in Middle East. Yeah, so he's keeping yellow card blocked. I think at some point, the pressure is building with yellow. Yellow just might hit you. Yellow has shown willingness to hit. Yeah, they just might hit you. And he goes for purple. Nice. Yellow's done. Game over. We see the full suicide slam. Oh, he's manualing. He's hoping to get slightly better odds. This is what you do, folks. You switch to manual rolls when your blitz is beneath 50% to win, because balance blitz will hurt you if you have less than advantageous odds. So he's trying to get a little bit better dice while he still has the clock, and then we're going to see him switch back to blitz in the last second, ruining both of their games. Yep. Okay. Purple and yellow are dead. Yep. and yellow are dead, which means that I can finally and hopefully take second bonus. I get a single card for my trouble. I'm guarding Australia with 15 stack. Let's see if anyone goes bad neighbor to me now. Orange sets in. Do they go for yellow instead? Do they break me in Venezuela? Yeah, you got it, buddy. You got it. Anything you say. I think blue's dead now. I think orange kills him. Yes. Yes, we predicted that one successfully. Okay. We're now in a three-player game. I'm in the middle position in terms of troops and in terms of generation. Okay? I hold 12 territories right now. If I get to the beginning of my turn, that's 4 troops. We would also get 2 troops for South America and 2 troops for Australia. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 is good. That matches what orange gets from North America, but orange would also be getting for 19 territories 6 plus 5, so they'd get 11. Blue would only be getting 6. So I'm in the middle in terms of troops, and I'm in the middle. Oh, and I get the 4 trade. That sucks. I can still take the kill on blue if I want it. Blue's holding 5 cards. That would probably instantaneously lose me the game. Well, maybe not, because orange has locked so much of their troops inside themselves. Maybe I should have killed blue last turn. Too late now. We're now essentially waiting for someone to overextend, right? The key principle of three-player is balance. And when someone breaks the balance of the game, hopefully in your favor, you can sweep up. So I'm doing everything I can do to not open Orange's big army in Alaska. Yeah, Orange has a really good lead on me now. I basically need them to overextend. All right, well, now I actually have to hit something to get a card. I actually have to block off my 55 stack, which I don't want to do. If I was blue, I'd really be thinking about getting orange out of that pocket. Let me hold 16 territories. Yeah, I think I can close the stack. I don't want to close this. I think I split stack. That makes more sense. So, I don't want to close off my main stack. This is also potentially a bad play, but we'll try it. So I'm going to split stack. I'm going to guard with 230s. One of which, neither of which are truly closed. But maybe we can work on building it to the Asian turtle strategy if I'm trying to be really greedy. Do we finally see him go bad neighbor to blue? Ooh, okay. If I was blue, I would be very scared by that. Sitting on 18 territories now, 137 troops. Yeah, under 10 off where orange is. Orange has twice blue's troops. Blue's sitting on 5 cards again. Would not be the worst time in the world to get that kill on blue, but he's not open to it. If he goes bad neighbor now, he loses the middle position. He's got some easy taken passes. Okay, fine by me. Makes me hit a 3. Oh, I definitely hit a 3. Do we see Blue knock that 47 out of the position? I think we don't. I think Blue is a cautious player. He's just playing his seat. Yeah. I definitely hit a 3. But I hit the 3 that doesn't open the 42. I lose no troops. It's a very balanced 3-player game. Nobody's overextending. Blue is playing their seat well, so they're not overextending, and then Orange is playing their winning seat poorly. So my thinking should be right now, how do I put them in a situation where they hit each other instead? So I think my move... I want to be lined up to kill Blue, but I think I give that up. Tell Orange I have to hit him. So either I hit him and break his bonus, or he lets me hit him somewhere else. Card blocking me is dumb. Yep, sets in. Puts his whole stack there. Yep. Has the option to invade from the 47. Moves here. Doesn't give me a card. All right, we'll put Blue in the lead. Orange still in the lead. Okay, so now what Orange can do is they can take the 47 down and clean out the position. This should scare Blue, because we can't let Orange hold North and South America, which will force Blue's hand to hopefully get involved in the game. Yes, this move came as a shock to nobody. Okay, so Blue and Orange are now tied up in terms of troops. The game's still very balanced. Blue has a single troop lead. Now I figure Blue's choices are either to take South America, or my hope is interrupt North America. Does he hit the 29? Yes, now we're talking. Game is still balanced, with Blue in the lead at 122, and I'm tied up to Orange now. So we've switched, right? Myself and Orange were... Orange had a lead on me, but we were both ahead of Blue. Now Blue is in the lead. Blue's a better player than Orange. How does Orange get out of this situation? Orange can mobilize his 42. I think Orange breaks Africa. Do we see it? Blue wins this game now. Unless I can reestablish a rapport with Orange, or he overextends, which I don't think he does. But he is hitting a lot. Maybe that pisses off Orange to the point where he slams into Blue instead. That would be my hope. If I open the 24, what happens? Sitting with 107 in the Australian turtle, my line to winning is Orange slams into Blue, or Blue overextends to take the kill on Orange. I'm in the middle in terms of troops. Blue is 130. I have 117. Orange is 113. Do they set? I have an 8 set. I will trade that 8 set. Okay, they set. I think they're going to make a move. So what you could do if you were Orange is you could add to the 23. You could use your set on the 24. You slam the 42 first. Nah, he's not doing it. This guy doesn't know how to play. Too bad. I think we both get second then. Orange is too cautious. They don't know how to leverage. And they're leaving their biggest stack now locked for no reason. They've done this all game. All right, looks like that 59 is being mobilized. Okay, maybe it goes into me, though. We shall see. Blue's being really smart by not pushing his advantage. 153. I'm tied up with Orange. I think we see the 10 move into the 63. Ah, the 42. Okay. Orange is in position to strike. Who gets hit? Who does Orange hate more? I think it's me. I think I die. We're definitely trading here. I don't want there to be any incentive to hit me. I stack entirely out of the way. And my hope against hope is that we see Orange try to interrupt Blue, which would be a fatal mistake for both of them. But I wouldn't be remotely shocked if they just suicide into me. And let's see which way the cookie crumbles, ladies and gentlemen. Orange's turn adds to the 104. No, he wants that 10 there too. He wants it all. It's going into me. It's going into me for sure. Cocks his gun. He's ready. He's ready to take second in this game. Set? Let's go. That's going right into me. Oh, Loudy coming. Yeah. Knew it. Called it. Definitely called. Think he kills me first. Even though I gave him the win. I think he kills me first. No, he might be killing Orange. He might be killing Orange. Yep. He's gonna let us hit each other? That's funny. Orange rolls 4v4. No, he takes a card. Nice. Ooh, he's gonna kill white. Weird. Weird play. Deletes a ton of his troops for no value. He can afford to do so. He wants one of us to win this fight. Okay, well, here's the game. If Orange has a set on three, I lose. I like what Blue's doing. Blue's like letting us decide who wins or who takes second. Oh, no set on four. Oh, no. Oh, no. Just kill him. Make him die. Well, maybe I get perfect dice. What do you guys think? I get perfect dice? Ooh, almost. I don't think I quite have it. Perfect dice, perfect dice, perfect dice. No. Territory off, right? Oh, I pathed it wrong, too. No, there was no way to path it without splitting. I had to go up. I pathed it wrong. There we go. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Even if he sets, I don't think he can kill me. I should get second. He sets. Gets the 10 set. Yeah, punches me. Maybe he can get me. He has to split two, though. Oh, and I have the dude's trade! I have the dude's trade! This is terrible! What a terrible ending. Oh, man. Yes, take my Australia. Take it from me, my precious. Blue should just kill me for the five cards. Kill him. Kill him first. Make him die. Oh, he's gonna give me second. Oh, baby. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. There you have it. Yes, well played. It was a good game. I hope you all enjoyed this video. I hope you found some of it fun and entertaining, maybe even a little bit educational and informative. If you are interested in getting better at the game of Risk, I invite you to subscribe to my channel. Come along the ride with me. I have some exciting things going on the channel. Yeah, Blue was an intermediate. Orange was a novice. So yeah, much better play. And Purple was also an intermediate. Yellow was a beginner. And we see our rank sitting as a master 17,029. We've gone 52 and 62 on the classic fixed account. Got some exciting things going on in the Risk community these days. I'm currently competing in the Classic World Championships, the Risk Legends Tournament, and the Grandmaster Tournament. Stay tuned for content on all of those competitions, as well as anything else I'm working on in the moment. I've started my second channel, Free Pete. The link you will find in the description. We're posting basically anything that I can't post or won't post on the main channel. GeoGuessr Daily Challenges. We're going to restart the Waiting on Your Best Behavior podcast, and then anything creative that I think of and feel like doing. And also, ladies and gentlemen, check out Kill Pete Strategy Instagram. All links to all of that can be found. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and until next time, for all of you on the path to world domination, good games and good luck.